Inhibit if I do full flexion, not forcing, only full flexion. This is not to inhibit. Now, to be sure it's the knee and it's not the hip, I'm going to right the leg here, bend the knee, and it's strong, it's not the hip. If I stay the ankle, it's strong. The knee, immediately become weak. I need to make this first before the treatment or before any exercise or any other kind of exercise. Okay, why the knee become weak? Why the muscle become weak if I stretch the muscle? Probably could be stretching the quadriceps. Let's see. Is the quadriceps weakens? Then this stretching inhibits the muscle. The other leg strong? Is it strong? If I stretch the muscle only, weaken again. In both cases, the stretching the muscle is the cause or the source of the weakness of the knee. If I compress the gastric ligament, no problem. Compress here, no problem. Stretch this muscle, not a problem. If I stretch the ligaments, no problem. Stretch the ligaments, problem. Is it the collateral side? No problem. I'm going to stretch the ligaments here and do a PDTR to see if it if I improve this one disappears because means it's the lower the function. Again, strong, stretch the quadriceps, strong, keep it strong. Means it's the problem. In the other side, if I stretch the ligaments, have the same sensory problem, stretch the ligaments, reflex, test, swiping the quadriceps, and it's strong. Means both ligaments are responsible for the whole quadriceps. Now, let's see what happens if I stretch again this one. And PDTR. Go back, stretch the ligaments on the left side. And now, no more problem in the left one. Oh. Means this is not the problem, this is the problem. I'm going to lock in weakness. Now this is weakness all the time with the technique I'm doing. Let's see where is it. The receptor value is responsible. Also, again, quick. Oh. Yeah. this side is a problem that is above this one and is above the other ones. So, we can test what is the compensator. And the compensator is it is really strong. Now,
Okay. Yeah. No pain at all.
Yeah.